Ittaman is one of the prominent new media consultants from New Delhi. In his line of work, he helps traditional media organizations, especially newspaper groups, transit to the new media environment. His long 30 years of work experience as a sub-editor in Press Institute of India to the editor of timesofindia.com has given him a comprehensive understanding of the Indian media market. Apart from this, he's also a certified instructor who trains the Indian Army and police on self-defense. Yes, self-defense is the ultimate tool in anyone's arsenal. So, let's shake off the shades of afternoon siesta with some quality time in learning self-defense.
All around you, this you can use in your personal lives also, all around you, back, front, everywhere, is your personal space. The moment you allow anybody inside this personal space, apart from those whom you don't know, for instance, your family can come into this personal space, but the moment you allow a stranger inside your personal space, things can go awfully wrong. This is a rubber knife. If you can see the explosion of my hand, it's not like what you might imagine in the movies, you know, somebody comes and slashes at you. It comes at this space. It goes, it will come like that. The best of practitioners cannot ward off this attack. It's not going to happen in the hospitals, it may, but then it can get brutal also. People will come, break bones, do everything. It has happened. You see, all these one of these doctors was hit in the head with a rod, and that happens inside him, and we just don't seem to have solutions. So that's one part of it. Are your security guards equipped to deal with it? Those bouncers can do nothing at all. So it's like in the airport, if you go, first questions they ask, if you go to any international airport, the first question, why are you here? It's such an obnoxious question, but when they question you that way, they're trying to test, what are you up to? I mean, in the face, they'll read it. So your security guard should be able to read faces, read behavior. They must be able to sense trouble spots and deploy their people to cover those places from where the trouble can emanate. One part of it. Nurses, doctors, everybody needs to learn behavior. I'll tell you about street language. In Delhi, you obviously see it. In south of India, I don't think it's such a big problem. But women who move out into the streets, they might have this on their throat and they would be asking for jewelry. One lady, volunteer, I need. What if it's on your throat and I'm asking for earrings? What are you going to do? Suppose this is the street.
Simply, I'm going to remove and give.
Good. That's exactly what needs to be done. That's exactly, because you cannot face this. Like I said, this is very fast. Can you try and stop this?
No.
But see how the situation changes. The knife is on her throat. I've asked for the earrings. It is in my hands now. And now the knife is still on her throat and I'm asking her, gaadi mein aake baitho, go to the car and sit down. If she doesn't fight now, she is not returning alive. You see the difference? The context has changed. It's the same knife on the person's throat, but I'm asking for something else. And now she needs to fight. Now her problem is she has to fight a man who has a knife in his hands. Both are against her. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. Ordinary martial arts training will get you nowhere. That's based on rules. Two people agree to fight each other and there's a referee standing in the center and he's guiding the match. On the street, that doesn't hurt. In the hospitals, it doesn't work. It is random. You can't even figure out what's going to happen. So now she has to fight this fight. Okay. Now suppose I put this on your throat like this.
Then so I can't move.
You can't? It's so easy. The more power I apply, the easier the release is. Okay? She thinks she can't get away. It's the easiest thing in the world to get away from this. Okay, I'll show you something else. This will take some training. Okay, I hold your hand. I'm going to drag you to the car. Okay? Try to do what you can to get to release yourself. Come.
I will try to force
myself. Fight with all you have. It's about your life. See, if I drag you into the car, you're not coming back. Fight. Oh, no. Do it.
No, I can't eat
you. Okay. Hold my hand.
Okay.
Hard.
Okay.
without application. You have nails, you are going to cut my skin, that's okay.
This is also self-defense.
This is exactly what I am telling you. Okay, hold tight. Without application of force, I am going to release my hand. Hold. Hold tight. Harder. Bachchon ko samajh mein nahi aata. You understand Hindi? Okay. Felt a choke, sir? Have you choked somebody? Try. Watch what's happening to me. Choke. No, you're not choking me. You have to put your thumb here and start choking. Okay? Choke. It causes you to cough. And within 5 seconds, if you do not release this, you will faint. And after you faint, what happens to you, you do not know. It's very, now hold. Okay? Now watch me, how easy it is. The moment somebody touches, hold tight and don't let go. Okay? I have to raise my hands like this, hold tight. Hold tight. And don't let go. You cannot hold on. Watch, harder. I just have to turn my body and it will turn. Now, no choke ever comes like this. Huh? Sorry. Come here. So, I'm going to push you also. Okay, the choke will come like this. It will come like that with all power. So, if you do that with power, you have to push me. Okay, if I fall, I fall. There are enough doctors there. Push. Okay, go push. Now push. It's impossible to hold on. You want to? Or you want to try more? Okay, go.